So we're here today with Brenda Carter, who's running for state rep for the 29th district. How are you today?
Crystal, I'm doing well. Thank you for inviting me here.
Well, thanks for coming. Can you tell me what communities are in the 29th district?
Absolutely. We have Kegel Harbor, Orchard Lake Township, Sylvan Lake, Auburn Hills, and Pontiac.
Now, why have you decided to run for state rep?
Well, Crystal, I saw some of the atrocities that was happening to public education on the local level, and I realized that a lot of these laws were generated in the legislature. And then after going to Washington, D.C. and hearing a an official from South Carolina say that they were going to cut $20 billion from the education budget, and there was literally nothing we could do about it, I said, school districts are already struggling. Municipalities are already struggling. There is something we can do about it. We can go where the laws are made.
Now, what is some of your political background?
Well, I have served for the last 8 years, well, it'll be 8 years at the end of this year, on the Board of Education for the School District of the City of Pontiac. I also served the last 4 years on the executive track of the Michigan Association of School Boards. And in 2016-17, I was the president of the Michigan Association of School Boards, which represents all 600 school districts and ISDs in the state of Michigan.
So obviously education is an important topic for you. What are some of the other things that you would want to work on if you're elected to Lansing?
Well, one of my strongest issues I have right now going on in Lansing is what they're doing to the middle class and poverty all over the state. Right now they just passed the law that repealed prevailing wage, which cuts the income of our hardworking skilled trades. And they also passed some legislation that says that Medicaid recipients are required to work 20 hours a week in order to get their health care. I think these laws are egregious, but economic development at the cost of community development, there's something that needs to be done there. It's an overall attack on the middle class. It's an overall attack on people in poverty, and we need to go send someone to Lansing that understand those issues, understand how it's being done, and is willing to fight against them.
You talked about your experience on the school board. Can you tell me a little bit more about what some of your professional background is and what skills you bring to this position?
Yes, I do have a bachelor's degree in business administration with a concentration in organizational design. I also have a master's degree in public administration with a concentration in local government. I am the only candidate who went through the Michigan Political Leadership Program. That's a whole year of training to be a potential leader in this state, as well as I worked as an assistant city manager for one of the municipalities, as well as I'm on the Brownfield Redevelopment Authority Board of Directors and the Tax Increment Finance Authority Board of Directors. So as you can see, not only do I have school district experience, I have municipal experience as well on both sides, not only the legislative side, but the executive side.
And what are some of the other ways that you've been involved in the community?
Oh my God, some of everything. It's a year-round thing with me and my husband, City Council Pro Tem Randy Carter. We start off with cleaning parks every single year. We've cleaned at least 10 parks for the last 13 years, and that goes on in April. We're in parades where we involve our seniors, our veterans, our homeless. Our children are involved. Turkey baskets. Oh my God, we give away 1,700 last year. Turkey baskets in not only the greater Pontiac area, but in the greater Lansing area. So we're branching out, trying to service the needs of our community. One of the things that we really pride ourselves on is how we represent our veterans. We funeralized a 92-year-old World War II veteran last Christmas, but before he passed away, we were able to provide him and his wife with a beautiful Christmas where they got all the trimmings and treated to a luxurious dinner at the Holly Hotel. Want to give a shout out to Kano Phillips for that too, because he was instrumental in helping us accomplish that goal.
Now, there are quite a few people running for this position. You're running in the Democratic primary. Why should people vote for you?
Well, one of the things I think that I would bring to the table is representation, because I've served in a leadership position on the local, on the state, on the national and also on the international level. Thank you to the opportunity afforded to me by current Mayor Deidre Waterman. I was the ambassador to Kusatsu Shiga Prefecture, Japan, where we took 11 kids over to Japan, and they were extraordinary with the Japanese government. In fact, so extraordinary that over 35 Japanese people are coming to Pontiac this year in celebration of the 40th anniversary. So I do have a wealth of experience. I'm very knowledgeable in policy. I have relationships built on all levels, local, state, national, and international. And I think I could be an asset in representing the wants and needs of the people of this district.
So if people want more information about you and your campaign, where do they go?
Well, they can come by my headquarters at 331 West Walton Boulevard. We always have some donuts and coffee ready for you. Or they can go to my website, brendajcarter.com. Or they can call our phone at 586-701-0431. But I'm always there. My literature always have my cell phone number on it. So if you really want to get in touch with me, just pick up a piece of my literature. I'm going to listen to you. I'm going to answer you. Whatever it is you have, the questions, concerns you have.
Great. Well, thank you so much for coming out today.
Thank you so much, Crystal, for inviting me.